There's really nowhere on Earth that it's not impacted by humans anymore. And so, you know, I think it's important when you're doing science, I mean, you have to take that into consideration.
It was started as a conservation project. These birds were declining about 1 to 2% a year across their entire range.
If these wetlands can't keep pace with sea level rise, then they're going to be drowned out. And so we're going to lose those ecosystem services such as carbon sequestration, as well as wildlife habitat.
The problem we have right now in Chesapeake Bay is that our oyster population has declined by 99% of our historic levels.
You know, humans really impacted the environment through putting a lot of excess nutrients into the environment in the form of fertilizer, fossil fuels, or manufacturing.
Our primary mission here is research. Research that can be used to inform environmental policy, and that research ranges very widely from conservation biology to water quality to environmental technology.
So what we want to know is nest success. By putting out nest boxes, and that has been a good strategy for increasing the population.
If you're thinking about climate change, wetlands are by far one of the larger sinks of carbon, terrestrially speaking. So I'm mostly interested in the building of the marsh surface as it pertains to the survivability of these wetlands.
The reason we want to restore oysters in Chesapeake Bay is because they filter the water, they create interstitial space, which is perfect for fish habitat, and they create structure for predatory fish to come feed on smaller fish. So sanctuary reefs are really important to the bay.
We're measuring the growth of the trees along with how many leaves are there in the canopy, how are those leaves arranged, how is that nitrogen addition affecting the growth in the system.
And that is the primary focus. How can we take that good science and apply it to good policy?